On second down, Johnson. Farmer going to try the right side, and as good as Clarence Farmer is, you can see he's not going to be as elusive darting through the line as Brian Allen would be. He's got much more size, and it's going to be harder for him if a play breaks down like that to create. And Johnson living in the shotgun. Last knockdown. Brian Taylor makes the play in the secondary, and that is the dreaded three and out that Arizona will try so desperately to avoid today. Remy Peru. Low kick. Powell will still have to call a fair catch, one of the top punt returners in the nation. And now it will be Stanford forcing a three and out. This is what they've done all year, why their time of possession numbers are so lopsided. They force the three and out, they get good field position, and Ty Willingham gets that big offensive line back, right back on the field. 34-yard punt, no return. An excellent field position. On first down, they give to Justin Faust, who will back up Brian Allen today. Seldom used junior from the Dallas, Texas area.
And the coaches say that Faust is a lot like Brian Allen, but without the speed. But he has the elusiveness and the quickness inside.
With a backhanded compliment. I made a note of that as well. He's kind of like our fast running back, except
he's not fast.
And then Justin Faust, just 8 carries on the season coming into the game today. He most likely will have 8 before this one is over. On second and long, there's Briggs again, charging the line of scrimmage. Lewis will roll, in some trouble, gets rid of it, deflected, incomplete, another dangerous throw, and Michael Jolivet very nearly came up with his 6th interception. Flag is down.
This official is extremely precise, not just ineligible downfield, but on a forward pass.
That's the scouting report on Chuck McFerrin.
Decision.
So now, Arizona, after going three and out, would love nothing more than to force the three and out. It's 3rd and long. That's Allen going into the pattern. Lewis, under pressure, gets it away. Teo Johnson to the middle of the field, still on his feet. Trying to get to the outside, he'll be wrestled down, but has plenty inside the 30.
Teo Johnson, every time they need a big play, we saw it last week against Washington. When they need a big play, they go to Teo. And you know, he looks like a wide receiver right until he gets hit by somebody. He just comes underneath on a little screen pass, sprinting up the field, and then as soon as he gets hit, he looks like a tight end again. Hard to tackle.
He looks like a power forward after he gets hit. 24 yards on the catch and run for Teo Johnson. Those are some big numbers on just 3 catches.
I mean, Teo Johnson's like Charles Barkley with speed and hands.
We'll have to check in with him for a halftime interview then as well. Game tied at 10 after 1. ABC Sports presentation of college football will return after this message and a word from our ABC station. Time of possession, by the way, is pretty heavy for Stanford. We want to use that before it gets lost.
Okay.
It's time these guys to... The story of this one when it is over may very well be how Arizona is able to play defense against 19th-ranked Stanford on 3rd down. And with a chance to counter a Stanford 3-and-out defensively with a 3-and-out of their own, they could not make the play on Teo Johnson.
Well, Arizona is going to struggle to slow down this Stanford attack, and that's what Stanford does. I mean, they're scoring a lot of points in all of their games, playing against some very good teams, too. They just can't be slowed down too much.
Wells and Powell are the receivers. Won't matter because it's going to be Allen again. He bounces off the first hit and is probably sorry that he did. Because Kirk Johnson came across and nailed it.
He said every time you turn around, you would hear this guy, whack, whack, just hitting people. They had to find a way to get him on the field.
Now Brian Allen is very familiar with that sound as well. 2nd and long. Lewis flares it out. Incomplete. They had Ryan Wells. The 10-yard line, he was in possession, but it was knocked away. Jarvie Worcester. Taio Johnson is on the field. Three receivers here on third down. That's Taio Johnson at the bottom of your screen. Allen is the lone setback. Lewis going end zone. Powell's got a step. Touchdown. Luke Powell, 26 yards, and Stanford regains the lead.
Man, what a throw this is. As Luke Powell's running down the field, Brandon Nash running with him stride for stride in great coverage, and he lost this ball up. Brandon just doesn't have a chance. He can't see the ball, tries to get his hands up at the last second. But Lewis pays the price at the end of this play, gets jacked a little bit. Man.
Pacelli try to add the extra point. Stanford scored first, and they have scored the last two times to take the lead, 17-10. Flag down here on the extra point. It's been a while since we've been able to check in with Chuck McFerrin. Powell on the touchdown catch. Put Stanford back in front. Check out our Pacific Life game summary, and the reason Stanford has been able to come from behind in this one, not Luke Powell, great touchdown catch, but it's the third wide receiver, the 6'7" Taio Johnson.
Taio Johnson, he beats a linebacker on this play, then breaks about 74 tackles before finally going down. And a few plays later, he's the same guy. He boxes out Brandon Nash in the end zone. Nash tries to get the push on him, but he stops, makes the catch for the touchdown. A little bit later, he catches a quick screen underneath, turns on the Jets. Another big play on third down, refuses to go down again. This guy is unstoppable.
Six plays, 53 yards on the scoring drive in just under 2 minutes. It's a very efficient scoring drives in this one. 26-yard touchdown pass from Lewis to Powell. Another touchback. Aaron Love has no choice. Pacelli has been efficient kicking the ball off. Arizona will have to start at the 20 again, and here is where the Wildcats have gotten themselves in trouble. They simply cannot go three and out here.
Yeah, they can't go three and out, especially your defense has been out there, has struggled, has just given up a touchdown, and now you come out, you've got to give your defense time to rest because Stanford just wears people's defenses down. Give them some time to rest, even if you don't score, put together 6 or 8 or 10 play drive to move it down the field.
Jason Johnson has been efficient. He's thrown for 132 yards, but Arizona has not run the ball. They got the one big play from Farmer, but it was a catch and run, not a throw. Johnson again will throw over the middle. It's dropped. Bobby Wade had it and lost it. Arizona fans have seen this before. This is where it's nail-biting time to keep the offense on the field. Escaping the first hit was Farmer. Fights his way forward to give Johnson at least a fighting chance here. It'll be a third and 6 upcoming. On third down, Johnson throwing left side. He's got Thurman, but he's way short of the first down. John Makovic's team last in the Pac-10. In time of possession, Stanford is first, and there is already a wide disparity. Luke Powell back deep to receive the punt of Remy Peru. Second nationally in punt return yardage. They are on Powell quickly. He gets one block. Can he get to the outside? Not tonight. A good punt coverage critical for Arizona here in this one. Stanford with the lead and the ball when we return. Two straight, three and outs for the Arizona offense. Stanford has got it back. A big offensive line out there on the field. A huge size disparity between the small Arizona defense.
And Lance Briggs isn't out there. Shelton Ross is in there for him.
Even worse for Arizona. Flags fly everywhere. Kenny Tolan on the carry.
Tackle made by 58 Anthony Thomas and 38 Shelton Ross. Penalty flag on the field.
After the penalty, first and 5 now for Stanford. Arizona needs to see Stanford with a short field. First down and more. Kenneth Tolan. those, John, were among the loudest fans in college football when they were 0-11. Now Reggie Rivers, South Carolina, playing a big game at home. They are going crazy on first down. Kenneth Tolan making a name for himself. Not here, not that much. We've seen Kenneth Tolan. We've seen Justin Faust. Those will be the two backs who will have to step up here in place of the injured Kerry Carter.
And they like Kenny Tolan. Coaches told us that he has tremendous speed. If he ever is able to break something, he could be gone. Doesn't have a whole lot of experience as a he's a redshirt freshman now, but he's certainly coming along. They have great hopes for him.
Albuquerque, New Mexico. He gets 1 yard on first down. And Wildcats, they show blitz a lot. Complete, guess who? Teo Johnson. He's got the first down. And he's brought down. His forward progress is going to take him down to the 42, and Stanford moves the chains again. Time now for our Aflac trivia question.
Aflac.
I knew you were going to do that. That's why I left you that opening there. Stanford coach Ty Willingham's in his seventh year. There are only two coaches who have coached at the farm longer than Ty Willingham. Who are those two?
Aflac.
All right, that'll
all right,
be fine.
That's enough.
You know you're going to get another chance to do it when we answer the question. Ty Willingham can move up third on the all-time wins list for coaches at Stanford if the Cardinal are successful here today. On first down, back to Allen. Leaps over the pile and is inside the 40. And now that you've seen him run the ball 10 times, you start to see what we're talking about here, that there's always two or three extra yards that seem to come out of a Brian Allen carry that you wouldn't expect. It is second down. We got four on the play. Allen again, right side. This time he's got a big hole and he takes advantage of it. Another first down. Down to the 20-yard line goes down. He's got 18 more. He's closed it in on 100 yards here in the first half. And as Stanford continues to move the ball, here's what we were talking about. These numbers, Stanford, that number leads the Pac-10. Arizona, last in the Pac-10. Everyone talks about the great numbers that Stanford has defensively, particularly against the run, but they're not facing a lot of plays. Their offense is staying on the field, and that's why they've been so successful.
And they're doing it again today.
Fullback Casey Moore does not have much on first down. That is a monstrous disparity because it leads into everything we've been talking about. Third down conversions and time of possession in Arizona's defense, undersized as it is, having to stay on the field. He may not be on the field for long because Allen's still on his feet. Close to the 5-yard line, first and goal.
People always wonder, well, why does the defense get so tired being on the field? The offense is on the field as well, but there's an emotional component of football that when you're in offense and you have a 10 or 12 yard drive, yes, you get tired, but it's a charge because you know that you're succeeding. When you're a defense and there's a 10 or 12 yard drive, it's demoralizing and it saps the strength out of you because you know you're failing every play.
First and goal, only one receiver here for Stanford, double tight end, Allen. Met at the line of scrimmage. Joe Levitt was there, so was Worcester. That is carry number 14 for Allen here in the first half. That's a big number as well. And earlier we asked you our which trivia question, Reggie?
Aflac.
And the answer? Ty Willingham, two coaches who have coached longer. How's that for a legendary football name? Pop Warner. John Ralston, who of course won a couple of back-to-back Rose Bowls back in the early 70s before going on to become the head coach of your squad, Denver Broncos.
Yeah,
NFL. On second and goal. Allen again, no surprise. Arizona wasn't surprised either. He is pushed backwards. Going to bring up third and goal. Now, Jarvie Worcester has been everywhere.
Big potential here for Arizona to make a big stand, force them to kick a field goal. You would expect this drive has now gone 9 plays, 65 yards, and the clock is still ticking. Look for them to go to Teo Johnson again. That's who they like on third downs.
On third and short and goal line situations on 2-point conversions. Number 5, middle of your screen, Teo Johnson. Keep an eye on him because he can out-jump just about everybody in college football.
wave. Johnson has it. Touchdown. Everybody in the ballpark knew he was getting it, and they still couldn't stop it.
He plays this just like he's on the basketball field, or basketball court, rather. He gets out in the corner, and he gets himself positioned on the defensive back, and then he just sits like he boxes out, waits, times it like he's getting a rebound, and comes down with it. I don't know how you defend that.
What is Michael Jolivet at 5'10 supposed to do with Teo Johnson?
Bite him in the leg.
That may be next. Second touchdown of the first half for Teo Johnson. Baselli adds the extra point, and it's a 14-point game.
What a weapon. 6'7", 245. You can't put a linebacker on him because he can outrun the linebackers. A safety isn't good enough to cover him. A cornerback certainly can't do it. Pretty much everybody knows you're going to throw to him. You can do it whenever you want.
How about a safety getting a boost from the cornerback?
Now, there's an idea.
Arizona better come up with an idea because their postseason hopes, their season on the line here with a record of 4-5. They have to win their final two. Meanwhile, the Stanford Cardinals still holding out hopes of competing for a Pac-10 championship, and a strange day, as we told you, all throughout college football. Now, if you were to take out the subjectivity of the polls, Stanford, just based on the computers and nothing else, would actually be sixth in the BCS, but it's their poll average that brings them down. Their schedule to this point, the reason Stanford, with their two losses, is this high in the BCS is because of their strength of schedule. They have played, according to the computers entering today, the toughest schedule in the entire nation.
Makes it even more amazing what we talked about earlier, the number of points they score per game against these very tough teams.
This time, the Wildcats are going to be able to run it back. Across the 20 and out to the 25-yard line, and brought down with Gary Love. Now, Stanford getting help in the BCS from their strength of schedule, but starting tonight, they will not. See the teams remaining in their schedule a little different as far as strength of schedule is concerned. Playing teams that Stanford has already played, Boston College, for example, losing today. And everything changes. There are a lot of different variables, but the big game against Cal next week and Notre Dame here on ABC before they finish with San Jose State. That was a game that was postponed from September. On first down, Arizona has to hold on to the ball. Johnson again throws complete. Near a first down, was brought down as Bobby Wade again, his fourth catch of the first half. Team, 13 out of 20 have been through the air in the first half. And they move the chains. On first down, Farmer. And he gets himself a little room, but he runs right into Tank Williams, who will be playing on Sundays. Farmer will probably someday as well, but Tank Williams will be there next year.
Farmer only has 20 yards so far this game. We know he needs to get over 100 today. And I think they should do more of what they just did, give him the ball on first down a little bit more, establish something.
He has the big play for Arizona offensively in this game, but it was a passing call for a touchdown. Johnson pumps once, now twice, he's gonna run for it. Has the first down. Jason Johnson does not mind taking a shot for an extra yard. The Stanford coaches are amazed at the beating Jason Johnson has taken this year. Back-to-back first downs for Arizona. They're going to drive together. Again, Johnson's going to throw. He's going to throw deep, and there is nobody even close. Bobby Wade was the closest Wildcat there. It was Reuben Carter on the coverage.
Yeah, drastic miscommunication there. Now, as a former running back, I have to defend receivers, running backs, tight ends. When something like that happens, it's always the quarterback. They always say, oh, well, the quarterback knew where he was going. The receiver made a mistake. I think the quarterback messed up that time.
Uh-huh, sure you do.
Bobby Wade wouldn't make a mistake.
Bobby Wade, yep, around 100 yards. He only had four catches. Arizona, again, just going through the air, through the air, through the air. And remember that Stanford's defensive front is all banged up. Johnson gets rid of it. Caught. Great catch. Hanging onto it was Brandon Marshall. Up near another Arizona first down. Thing is a route runner, and he ran that route impressively. It's another first down, an 11-yard catch. Arizona just throwing the ball left and right.
pitch comes to Farmer, finds the seam, lost the football. And Stanford has it back. That's a killer.
Second Arizona turnover, Matt Fredericks, Mike the linebacker in Carlsbad, California, on the recovery. Oh, Stanford has that big offensive line back on the field. Allen runs behind it again, spins off the first hit, gets another two or three extra yards.
He just runs bigger than he looks. He runs faster than he looks. He just does everything that you wouldn't expect him to be able to do, but he is just a very, very good running back.
The gain out of the 41-yard line, second down.
That was Justin Faust, not Brian Allen.
Well, he's just like Allen, except not the speed.
Yeah, he's going to try the corner, and he's got enough speed to get the corner before he's pushed out at midfield. Kirk Johnson on the hit. And this three-headed monster here of Faust, Kenneth Tolan, and Brian Allen is getting it done for Stanford on the ground.
And it really, what a blessing for Brian Allen, because he is the star. But to have these guys come on the field and spell him and do a good job when they're on the field, the coaches can have confidence that they can give Brian Allen the rest that he needs.
He's gotten the rest that he needs. That's Nick Sebas. Wide receiver going in motion. Allen back in the game. Bounces off the pile and fights forward. Stop me if you've heard this before. Five more yards. You know what that is, Reggie?
Hey.
That would be the homecoming king and queen.
Which is which?
Well, I'll give you two guesses.
Queen on the left. Were you ever the homecoming king?
I don't believe I was ever homecoming king, although I'll have to check my yearbook. Second down, Allen is the lone setback. Three receivers, Allen will get it. This time there will be no second effort, no extra yardage, and a pretty big third down play for late in the second quarter is coming up. Arizona's gonna cry if they can't get any third down stops. This would be a big one here on third and five. Quick drop. Complete. Guess who? Teo Johnson. He's not done. Jarvie Worcester has to upend him at the 30-yard line. Another third down catch and conversion for Teo Johnson.
Man, Teo Johnson, there is just nothing you can do to stop him. In this case, I mean, he's just going to run a quick out. He's right there at the first down marker. Come up. You try to strip the ball away. That's not going to work. Try to hold on and make the tackle. That's not going to work. All you can do is try to submarine him and take his legs out. But I don't know what you do defensively to keep him from catching the ball whenever they want to throw it to him.
Sixth catch already for Teo Johnson. He's got a couple of touchdowns. And again, Stanford moving the chains. 15 first downs is a big first half number. Kenneth Tolan across the line of scrimmage has maybe a yard.
You know what Arizona might have to do, and they're already blitzing, but they might have to gamble more on the blitz on some of those third down plays and say, okay, we can't cover Teo, but maybe we can put so much pressure on the quarterback that he doesn't have time to get it to Teo.
Don't have those old 8mm films with the tape and the film running it through them anymore. Times have changed. Flags everywhere before the second down snap.
And a rare penalty for the Cardinal. They are the least penalized team in the Pac-10 for the past 5 years running. So now Briggs and company try to stand up on a second and 15.
That's what happens when you put all those National Honor Society and Merit Scholars out on the field together. They know the rules. Second and long, broken play. Chris Lewis gonna try to fix it. He takes a big shot, but has a lot of the yardage back. He has about half of what they needed. It'll still be third and long.
Man, nice play by Chris Lewis. And this is some of the playmaking that Randy Fasani brought to the field. Chris, this is now his third start, and we'll finish this in a moment.
Chris Lewis calls a timeout. Third and long coming up for Stanford. Tell you what, your team gives up 21 straight points. You better bring a little bit more than that in the cheering. The Wildcats need something here. I don't know if that's going to help.
Not a whole lot to cheer about yet.
Here's a guy who can bring a little something.
And what they need to do is bring him on the blitz, because we know that they're probably going to go to Teo Johnson again on this third down play.
Wouldn't you? Third and long. Lewis in trouble.
escapes, throws on the run. It was deflected and incomplete. The closest one to it actually was going to be Jarvie Worcester. There's a flag down.
And now with a long field goal attempt.
Baselli's longest this year is 41. He did have a 52-yarder 2 years ago against Washington State. This would be a season-long 44-yard attempt. Distance is fine. Accuracy, fine. Result, three on the board and a 17-point Stanford advantage.
That's the fourth time now that the ball has fallen off the tee. I think the kicker, there's no wind out here, so it's just the way he's setting it on the tee. He's using the tee upside down. Kids at home, when your parents bring it home from Toys R Us, don't use it that way. But it keeps falling off the tee, and now the ref has walked up there with him six times.
Don't try to blame it on the wet. That's probably what he was explaining to him. I think it goes the other way. Season long, as you see the 44-yarders. Stanford out in front, commanding lead. All three timeouts for Arizona here. 48 seconds to go. From the two, Love avoids the first man and lost the football. The Cardinal say they have it, but they don't.
Love lost it and Love brought it back. That would have been the death knell for Arizona. Love trying to make a big play. The ball comes out. But you watch, he didn't go where the return was designed to go. He broke it off to the left and gets outside here and just gets crunched between two guys as an impact fumble. And of all the types of fumbles, that's the kind that coaches look at and say, okay, we expect that that particular type is going to happen.
He did not move the ball to his outside arm. He kept it in his right arm and went right into traffic. 37 seconds and three timeouts for Johnson. Starting at the 35, throws over the middle, complete. That's the fullback, Detweiler, short of a first down, so Arizona going to have to take a timeout here. Second and short, but the down and distance doesn't really matter here. 30 seconds to go in the half. Johnson, all the time he can want. And he puts it on the ground, as they call an incomplete pass. Flags fly everywhere. It's picked up off the ground by Bobby Wade, but you've got a variety of options here as an official. A few seconds come off the clock, and that is the issue right here, as they're going to reset the time. 26 seconds is where we will play from here. Again, second down, but down distance matters even less now with those seconds coming off the clock. Johnson's got two timeouts in his back pocket if he needs it. Complete, Marshall, and out of bounds across midfield. Clock down to 21. Starts rolling. Johnson just lit it out of the shotgun in the first half. Complete again. Melosi Leonard. They'll mark him out at the 35. Cox and Detweiler are the two backs. Johnson gets protection, looking for Wade. Has him and lost it. Johnson takes a second timeout. Can Arizona put anything on the board before the half? Reggie Rivers, I suppose here you got to get the short yardage here. You don't want to take a shot at the end zone, because if you fail, you're left with a 52-yard field goal, which would be a career long for Sean Keel.
I think you've got to focus on getting 5 yards. Get it inside the 30-yard line. Give yourself a realistic chance to kick the field goal.
Johnson has deflected at the line of scrimmage, and there was, again, nobody close. On the right side, Melosi Leonard was the closest one to it, but this is going to be a very difficult kick now for Sean Keir.
And this ball does get tipped, and I have to wonder if he was just trying to throw this away because he knew he was running out of time and trying to stop it.
Travis Pfeiffer on the deflection. 52 yards. 6 yards beyond the career long of Sean Keel. This would be a big lift for Arizona going into the locker room. Distance, How about that? Not even close, with plenty to spare. The head coach likes it. Why not? The Arizona Wildcats